to take this off my screen.
Make sure it goes into the pot, not your pot. quiet, Jose?
Thankfully, yes.
Good. Well, I suppose I should be getting off.
Sure, Arthur.
Morning, Arthur.
What's wrong? Thought you'd be happy to be off that mountain.
Oh, I don't know.
You ain't been yourself for a while. Okay, speak later.
Talk to you later.
Hey, Arthur.
Feels like we're back on track, more or less.
Yep, money and food. Now everyone needs to keep it coming.
For sure.
Hi there.
Glad to be off that mountain, Mr. Pearson?
Yes, indeed. Lots to do now.
Yeah, for all of us.
Keep your eyes on. What's he doing?
Morning, Mr. Morgan.
Morning to you. Susan?
An improvement on the last, that's for sure.
Well, that ain't too hard.
Can I lick your plate when you're done?
What do you want from me?
What do you think of your new home?
Doing.
I'm sorry. Just let me know if there's anything I can do. Okay, Abigail.
Settling in.
Good.
I'm okay. Warm, at least. Could do with getting out of here for a bit.
I'm sure. All right, Mary Beth.
I'm bored out of my mind.
Says I have to watch all this
days.
Well, bored is better than freezing. How you doing, Karen?
All right, I guess. Grimshaw's driving me crazy.
Well, so no change there. Careful not to work yourself to death there, Uncle.
I was thinking.
Yeah, does it pay well?
Oh, eventually.
So, while the rest of us are busy stealing, killing, lying, fighting to try to survive, you get to think all day.
Yeah, it's a strange world we live in, Arthur Morgan.
Do you want to head into town? See if we can find anything out?
Sure. I got some errands to run.
Great. Go check the horses are ready.
You gonna take the old man into town? Take us too?
Well, what you got planned?
Nothing. We'll find something for y'all two to do. We always do.
We're bored out of our minds. Been cooped up here for 2 weeks now.
Karen's about ready to murder Grimshaw.
Can Miss Grimshaw spare you?
Can Miss Grimshaw spare you? What's happened to you, Arthur? Three young, healthy women want you to take them a robbing. You're worried about house chores. Let's go.
Fair enough. You got me. Come on in.
I can't believe we're going to see civilization. Feels like weeks since we did.
Yeah, Valentine.
Very embodiment of civilization.
Ladies are going to love it.
Okay, then. Let's go.
All right. Out through the trees here, then take a left.
Yep.
Couldn't help me get my other horse back from over there, could you?
Sure, no problem.
Thanks. It's the white one over there.
You can do it, Arthur.
Hey, easy now.
Whoa.
Come on.
You're a gentleman, sir. A gentleman.
No, not really. I was just trying to impress the women.
Well, anyway, thank you.
Problem.
funny.
This looks like a decent little town. Other people, finally. Look at all that snow on the mountains.
Sure don't want to be back up there.
You think we should have asked Mom to come with us?
Oh, no. Miss O'Shea is far too high and mighty now for the likes of us. Or to do any real work. She's a society lady now.
Go left here, down the main street.
There's always on the right. Sure you can pick up some bounties there, Arthur.
Heaven forbid you put your head on the line.
Yeah, well, that's a young man's game.
Ooh, yes. We can get up to some mischief here, all right.
Just remember, keep a low profile.
Will you remember that, though, Arthur?
Probably not.
Let's park up down the end there, near the station.
Just what's your issue?
All right. Here we are, just like I said. Cultural center of civilization. Man at its finest.
Okay. What are we doing?
Well, we're going to do what any self-respecting maniac does. Put the women to work.
With pleasure. We'll start at the saloon.
Okay, just stay out of trouble. Don't get yourself noticed.
All right, I need to get something from the store.
Okay, well, we'll see you at the general store when you're done.
Come on.
So that's how you see yourself, is it? Maniac? Oh, yeah. In my years, I used to be known as the one-shot kid. Okay. I'm not gonna ask why.
You are a sad man, Arthur Morgan.
But I know you love me. Desperately. You're my favorite parasite. No. You're always my favorite parasite. You're my second favorite parasite.
Very funny.
I lied. Ringworm, then rats with the plague, then you.
Shut up. This is the place now. Come on.
Boy.
So, what do you need?
Hell, a drop of whiskey for a start. Well, something to pass the time while we're waiting on the women.
Always thinking ahead, ain't you?
Shelves, but I got more out back. Whiskey's on the top shelf. Here's the door.
Okay, if you're done, I'll meet you outside. I won't be too long.
Feeling all right?
Singers! Got no respect for their elders no more. What do you reckon? Lamb or sausage?
Well, this is a sheep. The best in the state.
Now you know what the smell is.
That's a rock cheese, all right.
Look at this. A jaw heart.
What is this to you?
Got a lot to replenish after that god-awful time in the mountains. All done. Thank you kindly.
This should be the trick. Yep. That's fine whiskey.
That should do it. Let's go wait for the mouth side.
Oh, here's to your good health, sir.
And to being down here off that mountain.
Absolutely.
It's a funny world.
This time in my career, I pictured myself being married to an heiress.
Gentlemen, I think I got something good.
What?
I snuck into this fancy house.
Acted like a servant girl. Usually works.
Someone was saying her sister was taking a trip from New York or someplace. Train full of rich tourists heading to Saint Denis and then cruising off to Brazil.
Okay.
A train laden with baggage and passing through a bit of deserted country at night as to get to the docks in time for the tides in some place called Scarlet Meadows.
Yeah, I know it. Yeah, yeah, it's right out there in New Hanover. Right, it's real quiet out there.
So, where's Tilly and Karen?
I think at the hotel, they were picking up some drunken fellas that they was gonna rob.
Why?
Seemed easy. They haven't for quite a while.
I guess I'll go see if there's any trouble.
There's Tilly over there. That does not look ideal.
Excuse me.
Before a girl came in here earlier with a drunk fella, mid-20s, blonde, you'd remember her.
Yeah, they're in 2B upstairs. Are you, a friend of his?
A friend of hers.
They paid for the room up front, so I didn't ask any questions.
No trouble now, please!
Okay?
Fine.
You sure?
Yeah. Nothing to worry about. Just men. But stupid bastard was boasting about the bank.
Bank?
Sure, I know small town banks are usually a waste of time, but it's a livestock town. There's lots of cash sometimes.
Okay. Keep investigating.
I will. Thank you, Arthur. I don't much like being saved, but when I have to be.
I understand.
You okay?
Sure.
He only punched me. Arthur did a lot worse to him.
All right, then.
Hey, who's that guy over there looking at us?
Weren't you in Blackwater a few weeks back?
Me? No, sir. Ain't from there.
Well, you were. Well, I definitely saw you with a bunch of fellas.
Me? No. Impossible. Listen, buddy, come here for a minute.
I saw you.
Come here.
Come on, get.
I don't like it. Me neither. Go get the girls home. I'm gonna go have a word with our friend.
Be careful, Arthur.
Just a word. Yeah. Just borrowing it. Get back here right now.
Yes, me too. Now please pull me up. Please.
You okay, partner?
No. No, I am not. I'm a mess.
Well, you ain't dead.
Who is that? Brooks.
I think it's best for both of us if we pretend this never happened.
Well, I agree. You saved my life. You're a good man, and here. You want a pen? It's one of them steel ones.
That's very kind. But I'm not a good man, Jimmy Brooks. Not usually. You see, I was in Blackwater. I killed people. And maybe I should have killed you. Should I have killed you?
I never saw you. Not now, not never. You think we have an understanding?
Of course we do. Jimmy Brooks. I will remember that. I got a good memory.
I haven't. Not one lick. Not one cent in this year old mind.
Come on, girl.
You want to stay close to home? Get in your way. We help your money keep up. Yeah. If you want to.
This isn't going very well.
Apparently not.
This is Jim Boy Callahan. You, Jim Boy Callahan. The commissioner. Fastest left-handed draw that ever drew breath. He once killed 14 men in a fight at Beasley
House.
How do you mean?
I reckon right now, killing yourself.
Come on, son. I want to see him. He's a guy. I'm trying to write his biography. I think I prefer the deer. I'd like to kill him and be able to be Baltimore's finest ever gunslinger, or he'd kill me, and I could be set free from ever having to speak to him again.
Yeah, you're starting to understand something very important like that. The draw of the gunslinger. It's win-win, you and the deer.
That's great. Down, if I may.
Be my guest.
What's your name?
I don't have a name.
But you are a gunslinger.
Not really. And if folks who need shooting, I try and shoot in the back. All that other stuff is, yeah.
But you fucked me.
Once upon a time.
And you ain't interested in fame. But you like fortune.
I need money, sure.
Okay, and forgive me, mister, I seem a little desperate. I am a little desperate. This book, I've got to make a thing of it, and, well, there's a whole list of gunfighters, legends, every last one. Emmett Granger, Flaco Hernandez, Billy Midnight, Raph Bell.
You heard of him?
Maybe you can go and speak to them. Ask them about Fowler. Any of them get up at him? I can't believe I just said that. But
you want me to go and find some sad, deluded fools like him, ask if he was the greatest, and then if they get uppity, shoot him?
That sounds a lot worse than it did in my head.
How much you paying?
Well, a lot. Half the proceeds of the book, if you help me get it written.
I'll see what I can do.
Ha! Oh, get photos.
Okay.
And there are notes on the back of those portraits that should lead you to him.
See what I can find out.
I imagine we'll be stuck here upon your return. Here are some other flop house.
Looking for Walmart, you want it? It's fine, I see, because it's not that easy.